Hi guys, welcome ulit sa YouTube channel natin. So today, we'll try to discuss the next topic natin for the numerical methods natin, which is yung bisection method. So anyway, before we'll start, no, I hope if nakakatulong yung videos ko sa inyo for the numerical methods na subject or yung ibang mga videos ko, I hope mag-subscribe kayo sa channel and don't forget to press the like button. Okay? So anyway, let's start. Sige. So yun nga, tapos na tayo no sa bisection method. If you are watching this video, by now no, you're already done with the other numerical methods natin for systems of linear equations like sa Jacobi, Gauss-Seidel and Gauss elimination. Okay? Now today, we'll proceed sa non-linear na ng mga equations. So today we'll try to discuss one of the methods that we will use, which is yung bisection methods. Okay? Bisection method. So anyway, basically, roots of equations na problems, these are the problems concerned with the value of a variable or a parameter that satisfies a single non-linear equation. Basically, if we have a curve, parang we have a curve, and then we just want to solve no, the roots of the curve. Okay? Basically, ang roots natin is wherein if we set the value of x, y is equal to 0. Para bang f of x is equal to 0. Parang ganun yung pangyayari sa atin. Okay? So, anyway, one of the methods that we will use is actually itong bisection method. Now, there are actually a lot of methods that we will try to discuss. However, we will just focus sa tatlo. These are the incremental, ano matawag dito nun? Yung mga incremental methods or yung mga bracketing, incremental search method. And one of this is the bisection method or these are also known as the yung mga bracketing methods. Basically, from the word itself, no, bracketing, we will actually put, parang meron tayong mga brackets mamaya. Anyway, from the name itself, bisection method, yun nga, this will involve, yung method na to will involve dividing by 2. So, ganito yung mangyari if you'll try to look at the figure. So, basically, this is our function, yan, yung curve na yan. Okay? Now, we want to solve this value, itong root na to, wherein y is equal to 0 at a certain value of x, yan. Okay? So, meron tayong equation y as a function of x and then we want the value of x when y is equal to 0. Parang ganun lang. Okay? So, what we will do is actually, dito sa bisection method, we will actually put the roots in a bracket. Okay? Parang bracket or parang mga limits. Okay? So, kung mapapansin nyo dito, we have itong mga dashed lines na to yan. These are actually our upper limit and ayan yung lower limit natin and upper limit. Upper limit means the x value is larger while lower limit the x value is smaller. Now notice that the roots are actually inside the limits. Parang ganun yung mangyayari dito sa bisection method. So anyway, let me try to draw na lang para mas maintindihan natin. Yan. So draw na natin. Okay? So for example, this is your yan. This is the y axis. This is the x axis. Okay? And then, yan. Okay, so ang y, and then you have the x-axis. Now, let's just say this is your non-linear equation. Yan. Ay, sorry. Straight line, tapos non-linear. Yan. Yan. Sige, ganun na lang. Yan lang yung non-linear equation natin. Okay? Or siguro, pag ganito na lang, yan. Yan. Yan yung non-linear equation natin. So, what we want is actually to, first, no, first na gagawin natin is obviously, no, to solve for the roots here. Yan. We want to solve x. Ano yung x if y is equal to 0? Parang ganun lang. Okay? Or yung function natin, this is actually our yan, of f of x. Yan. So, we want the value of x if f of x is equal to 0. Yan. So, we want our x. Gusto natin malaman ko ng x. Now, for us to do that, kaso nga lang, numerical method yung gagamitin natin. So, meron tayong mga trial and error na gagawin. So, what we will do first is to determine a boundary. Okay, so meron tayong lower boundary at saka upper boundary. So, ang mga boundaries natin are actually values of x. Basically, for example, ito. Let's just say this is our lower boundary. Yan. So, our lower boundary is here. Yan. And then, our upper boundary will be here. Now, again, these are actually values of x. So, this is, tawagin natin tong x1 or x. Actually, dito sa reference book natin, this is actually xl. XL, L means lower, and then, or L means lower, tama. And then this one will be X, this is X, XU, di ba? X means upper, okay? So, ang gagawin natin is, we will actually have these boundaries, okay? And then just make sure, we need to make sure, no, na between that boundary lies our roots, you know? or not necessarily exactly in between, but somewhere in between. Okay? Not necessarily mid-span talaga, parang ganun. Okay, lies our roots. Kasi ang gagawin natin, once nakuha na natin to, once nakuha na natin yung mga boundary natin, we will actually have our new, parang, from the boundary, we will actually, parang paliliitan natin ang boundary until such time, okay, parang mag-coincide na ang boundary natin with the location of the root. Parang ganun yung gagawin natin. So, ang first na gagawin natin is, ito yung initial boundary. Ang next is to determine what is the next boundary. Okay, so from the method, from the name of the method, which is bisection method, what we will do is actually to divide the boundary into two. Okay, so meaning our next boundary is here. Our next possible boundary will be here, ito. Yeah, so tawagin natin itong, divided by two, so obviously mid-span talaga dito. Now tawagin natin itong XR, kasi yan yung tinawag dito, yan XR. That it will be XR. Okay? So, ang gagawin natin is, once alam na natin yung pangatlong boundary, actually, dalawa ang initial boundary natin, we need to determine asan dyan pasok yung root. So, obviously, the new root is actually here. Diba? Sa dalawang boundary nito. So, after nyan, once alam natin na nandyan na yung bagong roots, itong dalawang boundary, ito na yung bagong boundary natin. So, ito na yung ang XR natin sa first iteration, ito na yung bagong XL, lower limit, and then ito na yung bagong upper limit. Okay? And the next, hatiin naman natin kasi bisection method kasi always tayo naghahati dito. So, again, hatiin na naman natin. Yan. Yan. So, I think nag-gets nyo na yung parang idea nitong bisection method. So, basically, yan. Okay? So, always tayo, ang gagawin na natin no, is to determine, again, initial boundary. And then, hatiin natin. Okay? Tapos, meron tayong bagong boundaries. And then, hatiin naman natin. Meron tayong bagong boundaries. Until such time, our initial guesses will actually coincide with the actual root. Okay? So, ang problem nga lang dito is, how do we determine na yung root natin is actually, ang yung root natin is actually within our boundary? Now, one of the checklist, no, or paano natin i-check if ever that is somewhere in between is to get a negative value. So, ang ginagawa natin dito is ganito. So, for example, ito lang. Ilalagay ko dito. Ayan. So, ito yung, Ito pala. Ayan. So, ito yung upper limit natin. Ayan. Ito yung, ito yung lower limit natin, XL. Ayan. Okay? So, what we will do is actually, we will solve F. Ayan. We will try to solve itong value na to. Hanapin natin yung value na to. Oops, yan pala. So, we will try to solve f, yan. F as a function of xl, and f, yan, f as a function of xu. So, obviously, f as a function of xl, since our, yan, since yung root na yan is actually below, no? Ito. Yan, so, ang value nito is obviously negative. Y will be negative. So, meaning this is less than 0 or a negative value, and then this one will be a positive value. So, basically, we can determine if our root is inside, if we will try to multiply, if our f x sub u multiplied by f x sub l is actually a negative value. If multiply natin yan, so pag negative value, then therefore, we can say no, that the root lies somewhere in between, or at least one root lies somewhere in between. Kasi obviously, no, pag continuous yung imposible naman na negative and positive yung boundaries natin, and then walang root. So, dapat, pag continuous sa function, so somewhere there, dapat lulusot talaga yan. Okay? Merong change in sign ba? Okay? Hindi siya pwedeng pumunta dito na hindi lulusot sa dito. Sa x is equal to, sa y is equal to 0. So, that is one way, no, to determine our boundaries. Anyway, most of the functions sa atin, no, usually naman, no, meron tayong idea of what is the possible answer. For example, anyway, sa example problems na lang natin mamaya. So, ito lang yung medyo mahirap pa tayo, no, is paano tayo mag-set ng boundaries. And then, doon pag once na-set na tayo ng boundaries, the next steps are actually very easy. Okay, so anyway, let's try to look at these steps daw na yan, kailangan. Okay, so the first step for the bisection method is yun nga, we need to choose the boundaries, we need to choose a lower limit and an upper limit guesses of the x or yung roots natin. okay, guesses for the root such that the function changes sign over the interval. Again, why do we want our sign to change? Kasi nga, pag nag-change ang sign, it means, no? Okay, pag our, ito ba? Tingnan nyo yung ito. Okay, so this is positive, this is positive. So if you multiply positive with positive, kasi yung curve is above the x-axis, man. So yung y dito is positive, positive. So multiply, that is positive then. So meaning, we do not want our boundaries to be like this. We want our boundaries to be like this. Ayan o. Kasi pag ang boundary natin is ganito, di ba, merong root sa gitna. Di ba, this is negative. Yung isa naman dito, that is positive. Okay, so meaning, meron tayong root sa gitna. However, there are also cases no, na pag i-multiply mo yung dalawa, ito, di ba, this is actually the boundaries. However, if you will try to multiply the boundaries, di ba, this is positive boundary, positive din kasi the y, yung y niya is positive man above the x-axis. But notice na meron tayong roots dito. Actually, pwede din. However, hindi kasi tayo sure. Pwede kasing dalawa or pwede ding wala kagaya nito. So, I think it's best no, na ang boundaries natin will have a negative value. Pag multiply natin ba, para negative and positive will have a negative value. Meaning, sure tayo na merong root. So, basically, ganito yan. If our, if ang boundaries natin, if the boundaries by fxl and fxu is negative, meaning we have an odd number of roots. We have 1, 3, or 5 roots. Okay? However, pag yung boundaries natin, positive, there are either 0 roots or 2, 4, 6 roots, even roots. So, it's best na ang boundary natin will have a negative answer ba? Ito ba? Yung fxl times fxu, okay, must be less than 0. Okay? So, anyway, next. So, once na-establish na natin ang boundary wherein fxl and fxu is less than 0, next is to estimate the new value of the boundary. Okay, or our new boundary. So, our new boundary will be xr or, yung nga, from the name itself, bisection method. Simply, we will, our new boundary is midway between the upper boundary and the lower boundary. So, that's xl plus xu divided by 2. And the next step, and the next step is to determine if our new, ito ba, yung xr natin or yung middle boundary, ano yung middle boundary natin? Will it be the lower limit? Or, di ba, meron tayong bagong boundary. Magiging lower boundary ba siya or upper boundary? Okay, depende kasi kung nasan napasok yung root. Ang ibig ko sabihin, parang ganito. Oh. Yan o. Oh. So, let's just say ito yung, yan. So, ito yung y-axis, ito yung x-axis, and then, let's just say ito naman yung, yan, ito yung roots mo. So, let's just say ito yung boundaries natin. So, ito yung, yan, ito yung lower boundary, and then ito yung upper boundary. Okay? Now, our new boundary will be between the two. So, ito. Okay? So, let's just say this is x upper. Ay, sorry. X upper. Yan. Ito ba? Ito. Ang value ng x. Again, these are the x-axis and then the y-axis. And then, this is the xr. And then, this is the xl. Okay? So, notice that our root lies between xl and xr. Therefore, sa second iteration natin, ang mangyayari, okay, sa second iteration natin, ito will now be the new upper limit, and then ito naman will be the new lower limit. And then our xr will be, nandito na naman. Okay? Now, how do we do that? Paano natin i-determine yung, kung ano yung xr? How are we going to determine kung ano yung xr natin? So, actually, madali lang, no? So, again, dito. Yan, no? For this to happen, you can just actually, yan pala. So, you can just actually multiply the function, okay? If x is equal to xl, and then dapat, i-multiply natin yan, if x is equal to xr, dapat less than 0 yan. If that is less than 0, meaning, ito, balik tayo dito. So, meaning, pag ito ba, yan. Di ba, this is fxr, okay, which is, kung mapapansin nyo dito, sa, that is actually positive, kasi above the x-axis. Okay? And fx, ito naman yung fxl. That is negative. Okay? That is actually negative kasi that is below the x-axis. So, if we will try to multiply the two, if ang sagot natin is negative, therefore, there is actually a change in sign. But therefore, the root lies somewhere in between. So, ang gagawin natin is we need to set xr as our new upper boundary. And xl is same pa din. Walang nangyari sa XL. Tingnan niyo dito sa condition natin. Yan o. So, FXL times FXR, if that is less than 0, therefore, merong change, no? Merong change. So, meaning, dumaan doon yung roots natin. Or dumaan sa x-axis yung curve natin. Meaning, nandun yung root. So, meaning, ang gagawin natin is, we need to set the upper, or we need to set the XR as our new upper limit. And, same pa din. Return tayo, balik tayo sa step 2. Ulit na naman tayo, hatiin na naman natin yung boundary. However, okay, however, pag na-notice, if this is not true, if ever ba, pag nag-multiply ka sa lower limit by times the upper limit, and then what happened is positive yung sagot mo, therefore, wala doon yung root. Example, ganito. Let's try to draw down. Yan, and then yan. Okay, and then, this will be our curve, yan. Ay, sandali, ganito lang. Ganyan yung curve natin. Okay, so nandito yung root. Yan. Now, we want to solve for that. We want to solve the x there. And then, dito, ito yung boundaries ko. Yan na. So, ay, sorry. Yeah, so this will be the upper boundary. This will be the lower boundary. Okay, and then ito yung xr natin. Again, xr will always be sa gitna, 4 bisection method, kasi hatiin kasi natin yan. So, this will be xr, xu, and xl. Okay? So, again, this is fxl. And then, this will be fxr. Okay? Kanina, ang fxr natin was actually positive. Ngayon, this is negative. Both are actually negative, di ba? So, again, below x-axis, so this is negative. The same is true for fxl. This is negative. Okay? So, meaning, negative times negative, that's positive. So, pag i-multiply natin yung fxl and fxr, pag that is actually negative, di ba? Pag positive yan, that means walang change in roots. Okay? Walang change, hindi siya dumaan sa x-axis. Therefore, wala dito yung root. So, pag wala dito yung root, meaning, itong xr natin, baguhin natin to. Gawin natin yung lower limit. Para ito yung lower limit, and then ito, retain pa din yung upper limit. Para alam natin na nandito yung root. Which is why, kung mapapansin nyo dito, yan o. If mag-multiply tayo sa fxl and fxr, if that is positive, okay, then the root lies in the upper sub-interval, which is ito. Dalawa kasi yung sub-interval natin, ito, upper and lower. So, meaning, our root is actually on the upper sub-interval. Therefore, we need to set, tingnan nyo, we need to set xr as our new xl. And then, again, balik na naman tayo sa step 2. Okay, so kailan tayo ihinto? Ihinto lang tayo pag nag-multiply tayo, pag ang xl and xr is equal to 0. Okay? So, pwede na tayong huminto kasi yun, nag-coincide na yung boundaries natin sa roots natin. Di ba? Kasi sa roots natin, our root will actually have, you know, fx must be equal to 0 for our root. Okay? So, pag nag-coincide na, meaning, f of x is equal to fxr and fxl. Okay? So, lan, yung tatlo is 0 na. Okay, so anyway, again, medyo mahirap itong intindihin, no? Dahil nga, mahirap intindihin, especially if this is your first time encountering this problem, this topic. However, I think mas madali ito pag meron tayong example problem. Okay, so again, my students are actually civil engineering students, so ang gagamitin kong example problems are, ito, yung mga nonlinear equations namin are yung mga equations present sa civil engineering. Anyway, you can still use the bisection method, depende na yan sa function na ibibigay ng instructor ninyo. Basta, ganito yung concept. Okay? So basically, these are the two equations that is always present. No? If you are a civil engineering student, makikita mo talaga to. So these are actually the ultimate moment loads. Okay, for ito yung equation namin, no? For a singly reinforced beam. Yan. So this one, this is actually a design equation na parang mas a shortcut design equation to solve for the area of steel from the index, kasi pag nasolve namin yung reinforcement index, yan parang W. Yan, pag nasolve namin yan, we can solve the steel ratio. And then pag nasolve namin ang steel ratio, we can now solve the area of the steel. Now, ito naman, this is actually parang, this is more on, pwede itong gamitin sa design, but more, mas nagagamit ito sa analysis, wherein we want to solve for itong A. A is actually the concrete stress block. So anyway, I already substituted some of the constants that we need. So meaning mu is 200, phi is 0.9, and then b is 20.7, d is 300. B is 300, and then d is 480. Okay? So notice that the only unknown is in this equation is actually the index. Tawag namin sa W na yan, that is the tension reinforcement index. However, this is actually a quadratic equation, so we cannot actually use our method last time, which was a linear, diba? So how are we going to solve for this one? Again, we can simply just use our calculator, diba? Pwede tayong gumamit ng calculator agad, and then just solve for W. But for now, let's just use our numerical method daw, and then solve for the tension reinforcement index. Okay? So anyway, first, let's try to write our function as a function of x. So ilagay natin, or in this case, ang ano natin is not x, but the index, no, yung W. Okay? So this is our function. Okay, so sandali. Okay. Yan, kopyahin ito na lang ha. So ito yung original equation natin, 200 times 10 to the 6. That must be equal to 0.9. Fc prime, 20.7. B, that's 300. D squared, that's 480. Squared index, and then 1 minus 0.59. Index. Again, for purposes of discussion, hindi ko na lang gagamitin ng index. I'll just use x kasi nasanay tayo na x yung nandyan. X times 1 minus 0.59x. Anyway, solving for x, we can just solve for the index. Okay. So, our function, we want to write our equation as a function of x. Yan. So, meaning, parang ganito yan. So, that's 200 times 10 to the 6 minus 0.9 20.7 times 300 times 480 squared, and then times x multiplied by 1 minus 0.59x. Okay? Now, this is now our f of x. Okay? Now, to solve for the roots, okay, this is actually a quadratic equation, so most probably we have two roots. Hindi ko na alam kung same ba yung roots or kung ano yung roots natin. Basta dalawa yung roots natin dito. So, to solve for the roots, we want to set our f of x is equal to 0. Diba? We want to solve f of x is equal to 0 para ma-solve natin ang x. Bale, if this is the curve, diba? If this is our curve, yan, parang ganyan, we want to solve this point. At this point, x is actually unknown. However, alam natin na ang y is 0, which is why, diba? F of x must be equal to 0, and then we need to solve for x. Yan yung roots natin. Okay, so anyway, let's proceed sa bisection method natin. Now, unfortunately, medyo, ano tawag doon? If I will be using, if isosolve ko to manually, medyo matatagalan tayo. Okay, however, I'll just solve this one. Ipapakita ko lang yung first, parang first 5 iterations lang siguro. Okay, pakipakita natin yung first 5 iterations. Okay? So, to do this one, it's best, no, since medyo madami yung kailangan natin ng mga values dito, it's best to tabulate your, results ba. So, number 1 is, of course, yung iteration natin. Yan, number, yung iteration natin. And then, number 2 is yung lower limit. And then, your upper limit. And then, yung new, yung bang new limit natin, which is yung nasa middle, or i-bisect natin yung upper limit and yung lower limit. Okay? And then, we need to solve the fxl. Kailangan kasi natin yan. Okay? To check if ever tama yung boundary natin. We also need to solve for, sandali, gandahan natin yung table natin. Yan. Okay, we also need to solve for the fx. Ganito lang. Yan. Sorry, parang hindi kasya. So anyway, this will be the fxu. And then the fxr. Okay? So, yung xl natin, again ha, depende na sa inyo, but sa amin kasi yung tension reinforcement index, we want our value to be somewhere between 0 to 1. Alam namin na ang tension reinforcement index is actually a very small number, somewhere between 0 to 1. However, pag kayo, meron kayong function sa inyo, so dapat you have an idea of what is the possible boundary. Anyway, pag hindi nyo alam, then just set a large boundary. 0 to 100, parang ganyan, or negative 100 to 100, it doesn't matter. Mas malaki yung boundary mo, mas may chance na pasok dyan yung root mo. However, mas malaki kasi yung boundary mo, mas matagal mag-converge yung sagot. Okay? Or matagal mong mahanap yung sagot. Okay? Matagal mong mahanap yung sagot kasi, di ba? Mas malapad kasi yung mas malapad kasi yung boundary mo. Mas maliit yung boundary mo, mas okay. Unfortunately, mas maliit, mas may chance na wala dyan sa loob. But buti na lang ako, alam ko yung equation na to. So alam ko na ang root is somewhere between 0 to 1. So I'll set my, for my first iteration, yan, or for my first iteration na lang yan. Yan. I will set my lower limit sa 0 and then my upper limit sa 1. So obviously, if 0 and 1, meaning ang boundary ko, ang XR ko will be half from 0 to 1, that is 0.5. But you can actually use your calculator. Again, di ba? Equation natin, A plus B over 2. Or XL plus XR over 2. So again, that's 0 and 1. So that is 0.5. Okay, napakadali. Next is, I want to solve FXL. So again, for those who do not know what is FXL, basically, we'll just actually solve this function here. And then just set x as equal to xl. Parang ganun na yung fxl. Okay? Now, looking at the our function, if you'll take a look at our function, anyway, ita-type ko na lang yung function ko dito. 200 times 10 to the 6 minus 0.9 fc prime is 20.7. 300 b d squared. 0.9 fc prime b d squared index times 1 minus 0.59 index. Okay? Okay, so ito na. Nasa calculator na natin yung function. So, I want to solve the function if x is equal to xl. Ang xl ko dito, 0. So, I'll just actually press, yan, I'll just press calculate. And then, I will set x is equal to 0, di ba? So, makukuha ko, that is, uy, ano yan? Ay, sorry. Yan, that is, Wala. Uy, asan ba dito yung notation? Anyway, that is 200,000, di ba? Which is 200 times 10 to the 6. Okay, so ilalagay ko na lang dito. This is 200 times 10 to the 6. Next, I want to solve for fxl, I mean fxu. Meaning, I'll still solve the function again. This time, I want to set x as equal to xu, which is equal to 1. Yan, equal to 1. So again, press ko yung calculate. This time, I want x to be equal to 1. Ayan. So, ayan. Medyo malaki, no? That's 3, 2. Paano ba yan? Ito-type ko pa to. So, I'll just actually medyo mataas, no? Lalagay ko na lang dito 3 to 7 na lang or 3 to 7. Anyway, I'll just copy na lang. 3. Okay. Ayan. So, ano yan? 3 to 7, 9, 5, 9. Okay. 3 to 7, 9, 5, 9. 3 to 7, 9, 5, 9. 296. Actually, you do not need to solve this one. Ang purpose ng actually nito is to check if we have a positive or negative. So, I will just actually use the sign na lang. Yung sign na lang as long as alam natin na that is negative. So, anyway, lalagay ko dito negative na lang. Negative 3 to 7. 3 to 7 something ganyan. And then for the x fxr, check natin. Calculate tayo. If our x is equal to xr, which is 0.5, our answer is actually negative 253. So, ilalagay ko na dito, negative 253 something. Okay? So, anyway, again, let's try to get our next step. Again, tapos na tayo, no? Dito, yan, no? Tapos na tayo sa, nakakuha na tayo ng upper and lower boundary, which was 1 and 0 and 1. And the next is, pag-solve sa XR, again, nasukuha natin yung XR, which is 0.5. Now, the next is to determine what are we going to do with our XR. Are we going to set it as our new lower limit or our new upper limit? So, what we will do is we need to check if we will multiply FXL with FXR if it is less than or greater than 0. Now, balik tayo dito sa equation natin. XL, no, and XR. Ano? So, ang XL natin is positive. Ang XR natin is negative. So, pag nag-multiply tayo niyan, meaning negative yung sagot. Therefore, there is actually a change in sign. Diba? Meaning, dumaan tayo sa x-axis. Meaning, our XR pala is our new upper limit. Again, ha? So, bali, ito yung XL. Bali, ito yung tatlong boundaries, diba? Ito yung XL. Ito yung XR, ito yung XU. Now, nung nag-multiply tayo, yung XR was positive. Okay, in this case pala, dito sa figure natin, yung XR is negative, while ang XL is positive. Diba? Tingnan nyo, positive yung fxl. Walang fxr is negative. And then yung fxu is negative din. Therefore, parang ganito yung curve natin. Parang ganyan. Therefore, nandito pala yung root. Therefore, we will set our xr as our new. Therefore, ito na yung bago nating, yan, yan na yung bagong interval natin or bagong bracket. So, meaning, we will set xr to be our new xu. And then, ito naman yung xl. And then, hatiin na naman natin. Parang ganun yung mangyayari. Okay, so again ha, since we multiplied xl and xr, we got a negative value. Therefore, since after multiplying, we got a negative value. Therefore, we will set xr as our new upper limit. So, meaning, ito na, 0.5 na to. Kunin natin yung value sa xr. And then, ang xl natin, 0 pa din. So, this will be our second iteration. Okay? So, again, solve natin yung xr from 0 to 0.5. Ano yung kalahati ng 0 and up to 0.5? That is 0.25. Again, let's try to solve. Calculate natin pag if xl is equal to 0, again, this is 200,000 pa din. Hindi yan magbabago. Okay? Pag if f, fxu, ito, if that is 0.5, check natin, no? If that is 0.5, again, press the calculate function sa calculator ninyo. Calculate, and then that is, ano yan? 0.5, no? 0.5. Oh, actually, alam natin yan, that's negative 253. So, this is negative 253. And then, next is xr tayo. So, that is 0.25. So, calculate if that is 0.25. Yeah, so, that is negative pa din. Okay, so negative, ano yan? 744 something. Okay, so anyway, tingnan nyo, same pa din. If we will try to multiply xl with xr, we will have a negative value. Therefore, we actually passed sa root. Again, if I will try to draw, if i-draw ko na naman to, this is x, xu. Ito yung bagong xl, xr, and xu. Looking at our figure, tingnan nyo, ang xl natin positive, so nandito yan somewhere here. Ang xr natin is negative, that is negative, no? So somewhere here yan. Negative 7, ano yan? Negative 744. While our xu is negative 253. Diba? That is negative 253. So mga nandito yan. Yan. Okay? So parang ganito na yung curve natin. Okay? So meaning, dumaan siya dito. So meaning, yung xr natin, ito naman yung bagong xu. Yan, xl. Okay? Until, paliit ng paliit yung interval natin. Until such time na pasok na yung interval, yung bang roots at saka yung interval natin will actually coincide. Ang pangit nga lang dito is the bisection method, medyo matagal talaga to mag-converge, especially pag malaki yung, or matagal mahanap yung roots ba, especially pag malaki yung boundary mo. Okay? So, anyway, check natin dito. Asa na yan yan? So, check natin. Oops. So, ito na yun. So, for the third iteration, ang XR gawin nating bagong upper limit, di ba? So, that's 0.25 and then 0. Again, dito, 0.125. Okay? So, anyway, and then proceed lang until such time makukuha natin yung sagot natin. So, for my students, if I will try to give this exam, ang gagawin ko lang actually is to give an exam about the manual calculation, and then obviously you will also make a program using this method. Okay, so for the manual calculation, bali ang tatanungin ko lang, what is the fxr? Okay, what is the fxr at the fifth iteration? So meaning, yeah, bali itatanong ko lang kung ano yung fxr sa fifth iteration, or itatanong ko yung xr at the fifth iteration, or yung xl sa fifth iteration. Parang ganun lang. Okay? And then, obviously, I will be giving you the initial condition. Ibibigay ko dapat yung boundary para same tayo ng sagot. Kasi pag iba tayo ng boundary, iba din tayo ng sagot. Okay, anyway, let me try to create the program daw para makita ninyo how to, kung ano yung, para ma-idea kayo ba kung paano gagawin, paano gumawa ng program ng ganito using the our Excel. Sandali ha, check ko muna. Okay, so yan, set natin, sandali, lakihin natin, yan. Okay, so, gawa muna tayo ng, ano yun, number of iterations. And then, okay, and then ito, this will be our XL. And then this will be our XU, and then this will be our XR. I think okay na to. And then FXL. FXU. And then XR. Okay. So, yan. Again, anyway. Okay. So, I think okay na tayo dito. Yan. So, first is set natin yung input cells natin. Obviously, our input cells will be the boundary, no? So, ito. At saka, yan. So, depende na sa inyo kung ano yung initial conditions inyo. Okay? Now, the equation for XR, alam natin, this is just equal to, ito, i-add natin itong dalawa, and then divide the whole equation by 2. Okay. Yan, divide natin yan by 2. Okay. So, anyway, gaya natin, ito yung equation natin, no? So, sandali, kunin ko muna yung equation natin. Yan. So, ito yung equation natin. Yan. And then, yan yung equation natin. But, we want to solve that, no, as f of x. So, yung f of x natin, ito. Yan. Uy. Ba't ang pangit? Sorry. Yan. Anyway, that... uy. Hindi. That will be... Dapat minus. Mali pala. So, ito pala yung f of x natin. Yan. Okay. So, I think okay tayo dito. Yan. Ay. Yan. Okay. So, ito na yung f of x natin. So, let's try to solve. Solve natin yung, ilagay natin yung function natin dito. So, that will be, ano yan? 200 times 10 to the power of 6. And then, minus 0.9 times 20 FC prime, no? 20.7 times 300 times 480 squared. Ilagay natin. Close parenthesis natin. And then, multiplied by x. Again, since this is, yan, multiplied by x. So, since this is f of x, dito ko multiply. Yan, and then, multiplied by 1 minus 0.59 times x, which is xl. Yan. Okay, so yan yung sagot natin. Now, again, I'll just drag this down kasi, yan o. Same lang naman yung equation. Okay? Oh, so, tingnan nyo. Oh, wala pala tayong initial value dito. So, this will be 0 and 1. Ah, diba? So, ito yung values natin kanina. Okay, so, I hope okay tayo dyan. Now, next, diba? Ano yun? Okay na tayo, no? Meron na tayong XR. Next is, we will try to create our if. Parang if na... Or function natin dito ba? Okay? So, again, this will be the first iteration. Yung second. So, again, we need to check if ever, ano yung value ng XU or XL natin. So, first, di ba, babaguhin natin yung XU. Babaguhin natin yung XU if XR, sorry. If we will try to multiply XL and XR, if that is negative, our XR will be our XU. However, if it is positive, our XR will be our XL. So, first condition ko dito is ito. If, di ba? If I will multiply XL multiplied by XR, if that is greater than 0, therefore, nasa upper limit, may nasa second bracket natin or yung upper interval natin, yung root. Therefore, we need to set XL. We need to set XL equal to XR. Okay? But if wala, then just use the old XL. Yan. Okay, which is why kung mapapansin nyo dito, gumamit siya ng old XL. Bakit siya gumamit ng old XL? Kasi yung XL times XR natin, is actually negative. Okay? So, dito tayo sa XU. Yan o. Dito sa XU, babaguhin natin yung XU. We will get the value of XR as our new XU if we mag-multiply ito ng XL and XR, dapat negative yan. Okay? So, if, balik natin, if, yan, if ito multiplied by this one is actually negative or less than 0, okay, then our new XU is actually our old XR. And then, if not, kunin na natin yung dating XU. Okay? So, kaya, kinuha niya yung bagong XU. Okay? Kasi, nag-multiply tayo ng XL and XR, negative kasi. Anyway, I'll just scroll this down, yan o. So, di ba? 0.25. So, same thing, then dito, this will be 0.25. Okay? So, ang gagawin natin, I'll just actually scroll this down. Kasi, ito na yung, ito na yun. Yan. So, 3. So, scroll ko lang to until we'll have the same value for XL, XU, and XR. Okay? So, dito, medyo iba pa, no? Check na natin. Scroll na natin bababa. Diba? Medyo same-same na tayo dito. However, again, ano yung sinabi dun? We'll only get the correct answer if nag-multiply tayo ba. Dapat 0 na to, no? Yung XL, XU, and XR. So, scroll down tayo. Ay, sorry. Uy, ang daming iterations. Yan, no? After 54 iterations, yan, 0 na. Okay, so anyway, scroll down pa tayo. Uy, bakit ayaw mag-0? Okay, so anyway, this is already 0, no? 9.53 times 10 to the negative 7. Yan. Okay, so our root pala is actually, dito na tayo hanggang 50 iterations na tayo. Dyan, no? So our root is actually 0.1729. So anyway, let's try to use now our calculator. So gamitin natin yung calculator natin and then solve for x. So ito yun, no? Yan. So that is 200 times 10 to the 6, 0.9, 20.7, 300 times 40 squared. Yan. So shift solve natin. Shift solve. And then, uy, mali yung na-press ko. Apps ata yung na-press ko. Sorry. So shift solve tayo. Shift solve. And then notice that you will actually be asked for the initial value of x. So again, okay lang yan. 0.25. Malapit yan yung roots natin. So our root is actually 0.1729. Anyway, again, this is a quadratic equation. Let's try to solve now the other root. I-solve natin yung isa pang root. So, shift solve tayo. But this time, I will give x as 100. Okay? Para yung isang root yung ibibigay niya. Let's just say x. Uy, bakit 0.7? Let's just say this is 5. O, oh, diba? Ito yung isang root. That is 1.52. Again, hindi to pwede. This is an erroneous root if you'll try to solve the tension reinforcement index. Anyway, gusto ko lang ipakita no, na dalawa yung root dito. So let's just say daw na ang boundary natin is 1 and 2. Therefore, ang ibibigay niyang root is, di ba? 1.52195. Okay, so I hope okay tayo dito for bisection method. Now, ang pangit lang dito sa bisection method, number 1, medyo matagal tayo makakuha ng roots. Medyo matagal mag-converge ba? Kasi yun nga, medyo madami kasing intervals. Okay? Medyo madaming iteration kasi especially if medyo malaki yung boundary mo. Kalahati, kalahati, kalahati. Now, we can actually address yung mga weakness ng bisection method later on sa Newton-Raphson and sa false position method. Okay? Now, another thing then is dito sa bisection method, you always need to check, no, na, well, typically, no, ito yung weakness sa mga bracketing method. Dapat, yung root mo is pasok sa bracket mo or pasok sa upper and lower limit mo. Pag wala dyan, then you cannot actually get the roots. Okay? So, I think okay tayo dito. So, yan lang. That's it for the bisection method. If you have any questions or clarifications, feel free to chat nyo na lang sa comment section. And then, same pa din, the Excel file will be uploaded sa... nandun, ilalagay ko din yung Excel file sa description sa video. Sige, so... for number 2, I think same pa din yung gagawin natin sa number 2. So, hindi ko na lang ipapakita yung solution. Basically, number 2 is more or less the same lang dito sa number 1. Okay? Kaso nga lang, yung A dito is actually the concrete compression block. Same pa din, this is a quadratic equation. So, dalawa yung value ng A. Now, A is the concrete compression block. Obviously, the compression block is from 0 to the total depth of the beam. So, hindi yan lalagpas. Okay? So, yung boundary conditions natin or yung initial, yung upper and lower limit natin will be 0 and 480. Okay? And then you will get your answer dito. Anyway, let's try to ilalagay ko na lang dito. Diretso na lang dandan. Let's try to solve para diretso na. Kopyahin ko na lang. Ay, sorry. Kopyahin na lang natin. And then, lagay ko dito. So, paano ba ito? Delete muna natin to. Ay, sorry. Di nyo pala nakikita yan. So, I'll just copy this cell. And then, yan. Copy natin. Okay. So, ito. Buburay natin ito. Ito yung bagong function natin. And then, I will be solving for A. So, ang babaguhin ko lang dito is yung ito. Yung fxl yan. So, i-delete ko ito. That will be 200 times 10 to the power of 6 minus 0.9 times 0.85 fc prime 20.7 times unknown a, which is in this case this one xl, and then times 300 times 480 minus d over 2 or a over 2 pala, that's a over 2 or x over 2. Okay, so ito yon, and then copyan ko to dito yan. Okay, now take note our boundary, I think okay na to, no? Okay, so our boundary is, since ang tinanong dito is yung A, I want my boundary to be from 0 to the total depth of the beam, which is 480, or effective depth, so 0 until 480. And so dapat ang sagot natin, so 0 to 480 pala, not 180, 480, 0 to 480, check natin, so baka may mali tayo dito. That's 200. Ay, okay, sorry. Close parenthesis pala natin. I think okay lang naman, no? Pag walang close parenthesis. Okay, and then, I think okay na tayo dito, so. Oh, yan pala. Kaya pala, hindi ko pala na-scroll down. Sorry. So, ito. Yan, okay. So, our root is actually 97.61. Dito na tayo, dito tayo titingin yan, no? So, that's 97.6376. Again, let's try to look at our, let's try to solve now using our calculator. So, that's 200 times 10 to the 6. That must be equal to 0.9 times 0.85 fc prime a times b times 480 minus x over 2. Okay, shift solve natin. So, our root is actually na yan, 97.63. Again, this is a quadratic equation. Let's just say this is 1,000. Ano yung isang root? Okay, so the other root is actually 862. So, if ever I'll try to put this one as 0 to 1,000, check doon natin kung ano yung ibibigay niya na root. 97 pa din. It so happen lang, no, sa condition lang yan. But let's just say this is 500. Yan, di ba? 867 yung ibibigay. So again, ito yung may mga weakness pa din, no, or may mga yan weakness pa din yung bisection method. Now, we will try to address those weakness later sa new topics natin, which is yung regular fallacy and the Newton-Raphson. Okay? So sige, I think yan lang muna, and maraming salamat sa panonood. Sige.